Good morning, and thank you for joining us at Otter Dare and Kinglassie Parish Church for our time of praise and worship this Sunday, the 21st of February 2021. If things continue to improve, then perhaps it won't be too long before lockdown is eased enough for us to be able to meet again. As the Church Path of Renewal representative, Donald has given me the opportunity to lead worship and share the message with you today. I have to say, I won't be giving up the day job any time soon. Sadly, for us and his family, one of our senior elders, Theo Davidovich, went to be with our Lord earlier this month. His funeral was a celebration of his life and a legacy and challenge to us all. The message today will be around that challenge, faith and deeds. But first, an introit from the choir. Lord, speak to me. Thanks to the choir for that. It is quite a challenge to do this, as it involves each member recording their voice whilst listening to the music through headphones. Then we send the recordings to Angus, who has the task of putting the parts all together. Isn't that amazing what we've been able to do this last year, what we've learned and the new skills we've developed? A big thank you to you all. It's much appreciated. Let's join together in prayer, bringing our time together to the Lord. Loving Heavenly Father, we give you thanks for this day, for our families and friends, and for the fellowship that we are able to enjoy even in this time, through the gifts and talents and members of our fellowship and beyond. We thank you for Theo and the example and inspiration that he was to us all. Father, we pray that as we gather, even though remote from each other, we come as one in heart and soul. Forgive us, Lord, for the times in the last week when our lives have not reflected your glory, when the ways of this world have distracted us from being the people you would have us be. We thank you for your grace and mercy, and we pray that this time we share together will be for your glory and honour. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. And now for our first hymn, please join us in singing When I Needed a Neighbour.
I was hungry.
Recall, Theo's story was used by Christian Aid in their February 2017 promotion. The message of faith and deeds that he speaks of will be the focus of our talk today. First, though, let's hear our reading from Elizabeth, James chapter 2, verses 14 to 25.
The New Testament reading this morning is from James chapter 2, verses 14 to 25. Faith without works is dead. What does it profit, my brethren, if a man says he has faith but has no works? Can his faith save him? If a brother or sister is ill-clad and in lack of daily food, and one of you says to them, "Go in peace, be warmed and filled," without giving them the things needed for the body, what does it profit? So faith by itself, if it has no works, is dead. But someone will say, "You have faith and I have works. Show me your faith apart from your works, and I by my works will show you my faith." You believe that God is one. You do well. Even the demons believe and shudder. Do you want to be shown, you shallow man, that faith apart from works is barren? Was not Abraham our father justified by works when he offered his son Isaac upon the altar? You see that faith was active along with his works, and faith was completed by works. And the scripture was fulfilled which says, "Abraham believed God, and it was reckoned to him as righteousness, and he was called the friend of God." You see that a man is justified by works and not by faith alone. And in the same way was not also Rahab the harlot justified by works when she received the messengers and sent them out another way? For as the body apart from the spirit is dead, so faith apart from works is dead. Amen. May God add his blessing to this reading of his holy word.
Justice, joy, peace, My name is Theodor Davidovich, and I come from Serbia. I was orphaned when I was 8. I left school and was given in service to the rich man, where I served from 12 till I was 16. When the war broke out, I got my freedom from the slavery. I fought in a resistance movement against Germany. My brother was on a communist side and I was in the royalist side. After the Germans capitulated, the two sides started fighting for the supremacy to rule the country. I was a refugee when I left the country, and I was in camps like you see now in Lebanon and Syria, tents for 2.5 years, from one city to another, from one country to another too. It was the Christians that sent the parcels, the same as it happened now, you know, and I never forgot it. And I feel I owe my life to the cause, to Christian aid. I vowed there and then to do my best as long as I live. And that's why I volunteered to go and collect for Christian aid. And I appeal to all the Christians, your Christianity is not only to come and pray and sing hymns, is to put your beliefs in action, helping somebody that needs your help. You know, I'm on my way out. God gave me strength to carry on so far, and He has a plans for me.
As the body without spirit is dead, so faith without deeds is dead. There was a story about a Scottish rowboat owner that took people across the loch. One oar in his boat was labelled faith, and the other was labelled works. He would ask his passengers this question: which is more important, faith or works? Then he would proceed to demonstrate how they are both equally important by taking the oar marked faith and rowing hard, causing the boat to simply go round in circles, thus going nowhere fast. Then he would take the other oar marked works and do the same, this time going in circles in the other direction, again going nowhere fast. Finally, he would proceed to use both oars marked faith and works and show how quickly the boat moved through the water to the destination on the other shore, saying this to his passengers: this is how faith and works must work together. It is not one without the other, but both. While we are saved by faith alone, faith is not alone in existence in our life. I didn't really know Theo that well. My first memory of him was a joint service. I think it was probably communion, and I remember him praying aloud in the silence after the bread and wine. I felt a discomfort thinking that I was embarrassed for him. Then I realised that the discomfort was mine, that culture and tradition inhibits me. My hands stay firmly in my pockets when they want to be raised in worship. I sway a little in the pew instead of dancing in the aisle. And I let people make comments about my faith without really challenging them. And here is Theo, living his faith in every way. Spirituality that impresses people without improving people is worthless spirituality. Faith is not only about what we do, but how we do it. Faith must be wedded to God's saving faith. If it's not wedded to works, it's not God's saving faith. Faith and works cannot do well alone. They can actually be harmful if separated. Most of us love salt. It's the most used substance on the earth. It's a necessity for our lives. It's made up of two elements, sodium and chlorine. If these two elements are consumed separately, you would die. Sodium is a horrible poison. It can burst into flames when exposed to water and air. Chlorine too is a harsh poison, and if ingested will kill you quickly. Ironically though, however, if you combine these two poisons together, they make an ingredient that we cannot live without. Together, these ingredients act as a wonderful seasoning, a disinfectant, a preservative. This is the way that faith and works are. Separately, they can cause damage. Together, they are God's power at work in our lives. I tell you the truth. If you have faith as small as a mustard seed, you can say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move, as in Matthew 17:22. The church has a mountain to move these days, with people in need of God's saving grace. Do we have the faith to move that mountain? But first, you have to meet them in their needs, so that they feel they belong. And then, maybe they can believe. And in that belief, they too will marry faith and deeds. Amen. And let's sing again. As Andrea, well, you can sing along, as Andrea and Angus bring us Jericho.
Jericho walls gotta Heavenly Father, as we come to pray for the world, we look around and see how broken it seems. Disasters, natural and man-made, diseases, conflict, injustice, and we are tempted to despair. And yet, in every corner of your world, there are people doing good. Thousands of them. Those working with international agencies like Christian Aid. Those working with smaller charities at home and overseas in local communities. And individuals doing those daily acts of kindness that do so much to make the world a better place. We give thanks for all of them. Strengthen their arms. May they never tire in doing good. Show us where we can help to be your hands and feet, to demonstrate your love, to bring your kingdom closer. We pray for our own community and our own church fellowship. Be with those bereaved, those depressed, those struggling to cope with lockdown, the lonely, the chronically ill and their carers. Let them feel your everlasting arms around them. We pray for wisdom for our political leaders, facing difficult decisions over the virus. We pray for our NHS staff at the front line of our struggle with the pandemic. We must be weary of the struggle. Grant them the stamina to see it through. As we enter the days of Lent and we remember Jesus' time of testing, grant us the willpower to follow in his footsteps and be worthy disciples. All these things we ask in the name of Jesus and for his sake. Amen.
Thank you for that prayer, Gordon. Let's sing again in the hymn, "They Will Know We Are Christians by Our Love." We are Christians by our love. A fitting end to our service today, I think. And thanks to all who have participated, especially Angus and Andrea for their rendition today and for Angus's skills in putting this all together. And to you for sharing with us. Please look at our website for further information. And now our closing prayer. Father, We thank you for all the marvellous things you have done today. We thank you for your love that you have revealed to us and for the love that we share together as your body. We pray for all the words that you have sown in our hearts today. Watch over them, protect them. May they take root and produce wonderful things, things of beauty and great blessings to many. As we leave this time together now, we thank you that you walk with us. May we be alert to your promptings and live in your endless love. For yours is indeed the kingdom, the power and the glory, today and forever. Amen. There's a wee change to our ending this morning. Rather than Michael, we've got Theo and the OJs enjoying Love Train. Please listen to the words.
Listen to the words.